Not very good. But Ainsley and the porn stars, I'm sure, are going to be a lot better. Let's hear them. Take it away.
I was learning some of those words for the first time.
Nick Duncutt, we're all here. It was great. Very catchy tune. I think Christmas number one.
Glittery, spangly yellow shirt. Everyone else looking suitably rock starish. And I don't know what Hugh Edwards, if he was listening, is going to make of that, that lyric there. I'm not sure entirely what I make.
When you met John Pienaar today,
yes.
Tell everybody honestly what you said to me. You said to me, this is
probably the one of the best days of my life.
Ainsley, you are really quite sad.
Yeah.
Well, I meant the entire day, obviously. Yeah. But,
Ainsley, I can tell you this is one of the days of my life as well.
Too kind, John.
It sounded good. I thought it sounded really good. I was actually genuinely somewhat flattered by all of that. You know, it's a very bizarre experience and a bizarre song. But not everyone has bizarre songs named after them either. How's it going down, by the way, as you go about the country, delighting the pubs and clubs and student unions?
Very, very well. I always dedicate it to my favourite political correspondent. And we always get people to help us with the Johnnies at the beginning, as it were. So that's
won't go too far down there either. when you look at Leslie...
Hang on a minute, don't drag me into
what
this.
What lyric would come to mind for Leslie?
Oh, I think she'd be quite Minx-like, I think. So I'd have to be getting something based around that. I think so. I don't know.
Well, it's been an absolute pleasure. And I honestly have been singing that song all week. I can't get it out of my head. And I tragically know all the words. I don't know what that says about me, actually.
Yeah.
But anyway.
I can tell you that she actually does.
So excellent.
All right, guys. Thanks very
much.
Thank
you so much.
Could I just mention it's on myspace.com/ Ainsley and the Porn Stars. Thank you.
All right, OK. So it's going to be on the road with Ainsley and the Porn Stars, among other numbers on the list, Johnny, the 70s porn star. And maybe they're going to be thinking
it's John Pienaar, 70s porn star.
And maybe they're going to be thinking up about Leslie as well, who I would say, just briefly before you go, guys, tell me if you agree with this. Do you remember Marilyn Chambers, a genuine 70s porn star? I think Leslie looks a little bit like her.
We almost find the film, maybe. Yeah.
Oh, please.
And Leslie is looking as if I said something vaguely outrageous. But Marilyn Chambers, as I recall, very young boy at the time, was very good looking indeed. And this is meant to be a compliment, Leslie, as well as being an accurate observation.
Do you know what I think we should do? What? I think we should maybe move on, go to Australia and talk about the cricket. What do we think? Is Mark Pugach there? Mark.
What a surreal start to my Sunday. First of all, I thought it was Radio 1 they'd patched me through to. And then I'm just working out that that's a song about John.
Yeah.
What did you think? John Pienaar, 70s porn star. We've had a bit of a text vote.
I think it's up there with John Ketley as a weatherman, isn't it?
Oh, I think it's better than that.
Written about BBC stars.
Yeah, don't get too complacent, Mark. They can think of lyrics for you too, mate. Quite easily.
We also had a bit of a vote mark on whether people did think John Pienaar looked like a 70s porn star, and yes, I'm afraid, was the answer.
Yeah,
anyway.
That's something to do with my
What a dubious honour.
It is, it is. It's my sort of perm wig and my mat of black hair with the gold medallion. just about. And the way that I say to Leslie, would you like a glass of red wine?
Would you? Well, fine. Thank you very much.
Now, tell us about the game and how you think it's going to...